Welcome back to Alone With You. We just got back from the communications place, and we need to now go to the core and process our findings. Okay, I've synced the data you scanned and collected today out there. Thank you for bringing this to me. I have good news as well. I've got the holosim chamber up and running. The constructs of the four colonists are already loaded. Okay, good. So I think I'm finally going to get to see how this whole simulating the dead crew members is going to work. They're already working on helping you, but due to the currently limited availability of power and processing cycles, the chamber's a little shaky. You can retire to your quarters. When I've got the holosim stable enough for you to enter, I'll call for you. Nella? Nella, can you hear me? I'm sorry to wake you, but I need to show you something. I was able to make the final adjustments, and I got the holosim chamber nice and stable for you. I think it's best if you meet one of the others as soon as possible, so could you please go to the chamber in the South Hall? Time is of the essence, so yes, let's get to it. This one over here, is it? No, that's the mess hall. Just south of this holo chamber, and we can begin. It's here, right? Yeah. Thank you for coming. The chamber will only work at night, when other systems are powered down. It's a limitation of our current situation, I'm afraid. This also means it'll be in low-powered mode, too. So you'll be on your own in there. I won't be able to see or hear what happens. So the time you get in the chamber will be strictly between you and whoever you're seeing that day. In the morning, the holograms will sync their data and ideas with me. Tonight you'll be meeting Winnie Laurier for the first time. Since the comms relay was her domain, it makes sense that you visit with her. Remember, these holographic recreations, they're based on data backups I kept for each key member of the colony. They are, in effect, the very same people. However, after the rift event broke off communication with other parts of the facility, and I lost track of these people, I was no longer able to keep them up to date. These constructs won't remember anything past a certain point. They might be a little touchy about that, so please do be careful. Okay. So they won't know anything about the accidents and stuff that happened, I'm guessing? Or perhaps just the early stages of it? Anyway, when you're ready, just enter the chamber and use the control station within. When you're finished, you can return to your quarters. I'll speak to you again in the morning. Good luck in there. Thanks. You're very welcome. I hope these visits help us get closer to our goal more effectively. We've got an awful lot riding on this. Hi there. Don't mind me. I just need to finish these calculations. I'll be done in a moment. The AI told me about your trip today. Did you, find those items you needed? I did. I'm glad. I'm sure this must be very difficult for you. Anyway, I think I'm done here for now. I guess, let's just have a seat on the sofa. I could use a break. The AI has us all working quite a bit. We can simulate pretty much whatever we need in here to figure out how to best help you. Whatever you scan out there, the AI can give to each of us in here so we can keep working. It's a pretty smart setup, really. I chose to make my work environment this room. It's how I remember my old apartment back on Earth. Is that weird? Not at all. Thank you for saying so. It's not the most practical choice, but having all my old books here and this old sofa, it feels like home. Anyway, the AI must certainly be keeping you busy as well, so I'm glad you're here. And since you are, well, what would you like to talk about? Well, prudence would demand that I just try to go for the most important things since time is of the essence, but you know what? This is an adventure game and I don't give a damn. So, you pick. Well, as you can probably tell, I'm not great at small talk, but, okay, let's see. How about books? Do you read much? Given the amount of books in the person's quarters, I'm gonna say voraciously. Oh, well, me too. I mean, obviously, you might have noticed that. No, you might have noticed that, I guess, since apparently you found a bunch of my books. The AI told me about that. I really like adventure stories. Big, complicated ones. I suppose it helped deal with the relative closeness of living in the colony. I could imagine I was anywhere. And the Hudson Cartier manuals said that escape was important to thriving in a remote colony. I suppose that's partly why we are equipped with this holosim chamber. It wasn't standard issue, so the higher-ups must have felt it was important. There were programs that we all brought with us. I don't know much about what the other people did in there. Maybe some took exotic vacations. Maintenance Chief King. I think he had some version of his wife in there. She didn't come with him. She stayed on Earth. He never said anything about it. But I could tell it got to him. I mean, it did to all of us. But most of us were, well, alone. Normally Hudson Cartier wouldn't allow colonists to be separated from their loved ones. They came as a package, or they didn't go at all. Kept stressed down, they said. But William, well, he was a bit older, and the best candidate for the job. I suppose HC knew how important he was to the mission. Damn, I wonder what his wife is doing, if she's still alive back on Earth. I wonder if she knows, you know, what happened to us. Do you want to talk about anything else? If I talk about the colony, would that be kind of bringing up a sore subject that you might not remember that much about? No, I mean, just because I'm talking about the colony doesn't mean I'm necessarily talking about the stuff that happened after. I mean, we were here for quite a long time before the accidents happened, right? We had as much of a chance as anyone in making this work. In the end, I don't think I could quite believe it was going to fail. We all arrived here, 2048? What year is it now? 2064. Wow, so 16 years. So much has happened. And there was so much needless loss. By the time we all arrived here in 2048, the remote colony building systems had all the basics ready. Most people were pretty excited to get started. But I had a harder time adjusting. Space travel will do that to some people. At least that's what the head psychologist, Miss Bouchard told me. Something about how close everybody was, you know? It was easy to feel trapped. We trained for all that, of course, but the real thing is different. Do you want to talk about anything else? Ship's comms. Well, as I'm sure the AI explained, my job is to help you get the escape ship's communication systems repaired so you don't blast off into space with no voice. Even if everything else is functioning, you wouldn't want to be out there with no way to contact anyone. I think I'd rather be adrift than not have a working radio. But I think the AI's plan is sound. If you can contact someone from a shipping lane, you can hopefully arrange a pickup. Kind of like thumbing a ride back on Earth, I guess. I never did that, now that I think of it. I definitely was too, well, afraid to try it. Me too. I'd never have the guts to do that. Anyway, sorry, I'm talking too much. Odd. I don't think I ever talked this much before when I was, well, real. Alive. I wonder why that is. Anyway, so you were in the comms relay today, huh? What was it like out there? Well, she remembers the pages, right, in the book, because she mentioned talking about it. I mean, she mentioned writing it. How I found her book. So she shouldn't be touchy about that, right? I'll show her the pages. You what? Oh, you found a notebook, didn't you? With a story in it? Oh no, that's embarrassing. Yeah, that notebook is... I mean, was mine. I was writing stories while I... well, to pass the time and to deal with things. I always wanted to write a book, but I never did. I guess I figured it was my only chance to try. I know it wasn't very good. I guess I was trying to put my thoughts and, well, my feelings into some kind of relatable way, but that was probably pretty obvious. Yeah, other than having a character called Paula in the dark, it didn't really seem much like fiction at all. It's funny though, now that I think of it, I don't know how that story ends. I can't remember everything I wrote. Uh-oh. But, what'd you think of what you read? I mean, if you read it. I mean... It wasn't great? I want to say it's so-so, because that's the truth. It was kind of like a... It was too on the nose. It was supposed to be allegorical to what was actually happening, but it was just so blatantly obvious. I feel like it should have just been written as a... as an actual journal rather than some sort of fiction. But... is it mean to say that? I mean... she's dead. It was good. Really? Well, thanks. I appreciate you saying so. That means a lot. What else did you think about the comms relay? It was damp. The acidic rain must really be wearing it down, then. That was one factor that we couldn't properly account for. Hudson Cartier knew of the weather systems on the planet, of course. It had a decade's worth of survey data with which to plan for this project. But I guess a decade only tells you so much. The systems changed, and the acidic rain became much worse, and much more frequent. I'd be surprised if any of the structures there didn't suffer damage. In Colony B, we had it the worst. Things eroded so fast. The comms relay seemed relatively intact, but even so, it was tough to keep the equipment working. I can still feel the chill of that place somehow. Maybe it's a good thing you have that scarf. I could say, do you want it? Can I give it to her? She's a hologram. I mean, I guess maybe we could, like, program it into her or something. Do you want it? Thanks. But I don't really feel the cold anymore. Not in a real sense. That's nice of you to offer, though. I just made her sad, didn't I? We can program it into you to feel cold and then give you a scarf to try to solve the coldness. maybe not. What else did you think about the comms relay? Empty. There are 5 towers in the relay. You must have been in Tower A. It never was completed. The relay was designed to be redundant, so not everything is in one place. And there are always backups of critical systems. I was the one who designed it, or consulted on the key components, back on Earth. But not everything was built to spec. I remember there were some issues with some of the drones. We lost some capability, so we had to think on our feet. That's why Tower A is only half finished. It seems like almost nothing went the way it was supposed to. takes a waffle to think about all those people. I know. You have it worse, though. To be the last, I can't even bear to think about it. So, kind of sounds selfish, but as I work in here, I keep thinking about the fact that I'm here and yet, well, I'm not. I think, I feel, I can see you, obviously, and it all seems real, but I'm not here, am I? I'm not. I mean, I'm not really around anymore. So obviously something happened to me, I mean the real me, but I can only remember so far back. I guess the AI's version of me only accounts for so much. It's like a backup, I suppose. The me you see, this is the most recent version. But does it count? Does any of this matter if I'm not even real? I think it does matter. I mean, they seem to be sentient. I mean, they seem to be simulated to such a sophisticated degree that they seem basically just conscious. So they seem kind of just alive, right? Just in a different way than they were before? Yes, of course. That's sweet of you to say, but I can't stop thinking about it. Believe me, I know this mission of yours is much more important right now. Look, I don't want to keep you here, considering all you have to worry about. You need to rest, and you still have so much to do. But, do you mind to see if you can find out what happened to me? Maybe find some kind of record of what I went through? I promise. Thank you. Maybe we can talk about it some more the next time I see you. Take care for now. Okay, so back to sleep, right? Good morning, Nella. I received notice that the Holosim chamber had been successfully accessed. How did it go? Really well. That's wonderful to hear. I hope Miss Laurier was able to give you some helpful information on repairing the escape ship. Did she? I don't know if we even really talked about it. Did we actually even talk about it? Thinking back on it, I don't think we really did. We talked about the comm station and stuff, but... I received information from Miss Loria's construct this morning, after I returned to a full waking state. Whatever happened in there, it appears to have helped her problem solve a bit more effectively in regards to the escape ship. Okay, well that's good. I'm already crunching numbers on her ideas. I think this plan of ours is going to really help us out. In any event, you can return to the core when you're ready, and I've got some new mission options for you today. Now that you've been to the comms relay, and we have the Holosim chamber working, I think it's time to branch out a bit. You have a few choices. First, we can try to recover plant material at the Agro-Domes. We need to start equipping the escape ship with material for the food processors. Leslie ran the Agro-Domes, so if you head there today, we can meet her tonight in the Holosim chamber. Next is what the colonists called the Caves, our energy mining and processing center. The mine is available to visit. We could use more resources for fuel. Resource Manager Jean Lumumba was responsible for energy production, So if you head there, you'll see him tonight in the Holosim chamber. Next is, well, Colony B, due to recent shifts, it's finally accessible again, although I am reluctant to send you there. It's likely in a terrible state, but it might still have parts we can salvage for the escape ship's thrusters. Unfortunately, we have no choice but to check. If you do visit there, you'll get to meet Director Pierre Tong tonight in the Holosim chamber. He might not like what we discover, though. Discovering more about each colonist is key to our survival. The more you can connect with their constructs, the more help they'll be to us. When you're ready, you can head south to the shuttle bay to plot a course to one of the areas. Well, I can't think of any particular reason to go to one over the other. Caves, B, this mysterious place, and Agro-Domes. Well, Colony B sounds like a nightmare. Let's go to the Agro-Domes. If there's anything still alive there. This is the main grow dome in the facility, where the colonists use advanced hydroponics to grow base foods for processing. Base foods? You can't see it from the ground, but the top of the building is like a giant round basin, and was designed to catch the rainfall and collect it. Well, if it's catching acid rain and using that to water the plants, then we have a bit of a problem, but maybe it processed the acid out of it or something. The top layer of the building processes the rain to remove its acidic elements and treat it to be potable and suitable for plants. Well, there you go. Once you're inside, you should be able to see the various grow rooms, but my readings seem off. Something's not entirely right. That's not right. The decontamination chamber you're in should be scanning you and clearing the air of toxins before you enter, to protect the operation inside. It doesn't appear to be working correctly. Be careful in there. Based on what I'm reading, the facility seems to be in quite a state. Remember, we're here to find salvageable plant samples that we can use to keep the food processors running here until we escape. But first, you should find something that would indicate what the crew here were dealing with. Try looking for research notes on tablets or desks. It's interesting that they talk about growing base foods for processing, so it sounds like they don't eat the plants directly. So no, like, growing tomatoes and eating them sort of thing? They just get processed into other food? I'm curious about how that works. This tube feeds water collected on the special roof to the hydroponics systems here in the dome. It looks terribly corrupted, though. The water seems heavily saturated with the toxic material that shouldn't be in the system. Flower chamber inaccessible because of this huge root. That makes me think at some point I'm going to be able to get rid of it. Those vines are blocking the door. You'll have to find a way to get them out of your way. Leafy green chamber 2, that's open. Those research notes handwritten by multiple people. Things must have been chaotic. Based on these, I can confirm two of the crew members. Leslie, of course, as a facility manager. She was always on duty and she would have been here to the very end. Ashley Hainsworth, the chief genetics researcher. She and Miss Leslie, I'm not going to try to pronounce her last name, had very different points of view. if their personal logs were any indication. Meaning that they had arguments about Agro-Dome procedure and protocol in general. Many times. Miss Leslie was an excellent leader, though a bit of a reluctant one. She preferred consultation with her subordinates and open discussion. Miss Hainsworth, on the other hand, felt that leadership required a stronger hand, and as the situation got worse, their differences became more pronounced. Yeah, very open and kind of participatory and democratic sort of way of leadership might not be the best form when you're in an emergency situation like this. The dome is in pretty bad shape. It looks like walls have collapsed and there's a lot of damage all around. There are other labs around the other side of that corridor, but you won't be able to access them. We'll just have to focus our efforts here. Root and Tubers Chamber. Alright, so two places I can go right now. Let's go to Roots and Tubers. Can we find some space potatoes? It looks like a seismic event collapsed one of the walls here. You may be able to squeeze through, though. What are these fruits or vegetables or whatever they are? Pass through the rubble. Not yet. Oh, I'm sorry, Nella. You appear to have found the corpse of Arlo Jaeger, the production supervisor. His body is trapped beneath the rubble from that wall. It looks like he attempted to keep himself alive with the produce in that room, but either the tainted crops got the better of him, or help simply never came. Alright, that's all for this room, aside from that little spot in the rubble. Before I go there, though, I want to go to the other place. There are flowers growing at the base of the vines. They appear to either be resistant to the toxins that have invaded the dome, or a result of them. Likely they took root within the filtration and drainage systems below, and crawled their way up through that grate. That's a note from Florent Marchand, the horticultural technician. It reads, "The ceiling tracks were damaged by the sudden growth of vines. Due to damage, auto sprinklers haven't been able to move correctly. This room is probably beyond repair." Okay, looks like that's it for here. Let's go through the little rubble thing. It's a note from horticultural technician Florent Marchand. Special ventilation for this room is permanently shut down. Nothing we can do about it. There's an addition. If you two could have stopped bickering, maybe you'd have done your job and these crops wouldn't have failed. Is that it for this place? Well, I must be missing something, right? Because where do I go now? I must have missed something very big. Can't pass through there. Oh, is that a doorway? Oh, Lagoons, Chamber 2. Leafy Greens, Chamber 1, inaccessible. Okay, yeah, I missed this. Thorn Merchant. Merchant, rather. Please note, solution tubes are leaking due to faulty seals. New ones are being printed and will be installed. I know it sucks, but I'm backed up with repair requests. Agroponics Dome Administration. This looks like where I'm gonna be able to take care of some stuff. There are an assortment of reference texts as well as leisure reading on the shelf. There's also a collection of holotapes. Oh my, they look to be bootleg movies. There are drama, action, and even romance films, all entirely illegal copies that someone must have covertly brought with them. Or scanned via the interspace net. If the situation wasn't so dire, I would be inclined to note this in my next report to Hudson Cartier Mission Control, but given the circumstances, it hardly seems a priority. That wall-mounted cot is similar to your own bed. It was meant for short-term rests for the colonists who worked there. Sometimes longer than normal hours were required, and that break room was used as a temporary sleeping quarters often. Work. You found something that can help us. According to these notes, a toxin of some kind compromised the whole facility, impacting food growth. There's a detailed analysis on the toxin here. I might be able to use these formulae to reconfigure your scanner. Yes, this will work. You should be able to scan whatever plant life you come across now, and determine if it's suitable for processing. We need to find specimens that are at least 60% viable for processing. Excellent. Find. The datapad still has some power left, and doesn't seem to be password protected. Let me see if there's anything of use. It seems to contain a private chat thread between Ashley, the chief genetic researcher, and Arlo, the production supervisor. I'll read it to you. Ashley. So now you see what I mean? Arlo. Yeah, it's like she's afraid to make a decision. Ashley. Exactly. She seems to freeze when things like this happen. Arlo. I agree that the situation with the toxins needs to be dealt with more quickly. Ashley, don't be so diplomatic. You're sounding like her. I think we have a huge problem here. She needs to make a decision. The chat log ends there. It seems like some of Leslie's subordinates didn't agree with her leadership style. Another note from Florin Marchand. Use of the processing machine without my say-so is expressly forbidden. Since you keep going around my back, I've password locked it. You want in? Pay attention to my warnings next time. Oh. It's the stuff that's in bold on the warnings, isn't it? And I have to actually enter it? Do you want to enter a passcode? No. I think I gotta go back and look at the warnings. Also, I've got some things to scan. Start here. Oh, there we go. Rampion, an ancient earth vegetable. Geneticists recently revived the strain for its hardiness and nutrition. Excellent work. Sleevey Green is still 75% viable for processing. That spinach is generally quite rich in nutrients. Lab modifications have made it exceptionally so. It's been compromised somewhat by the environment, but we can still use some of it. 61% viable. Good, good, good. Oh wait, was there a warning up there? Gotta look for the warnings. This. Okay. I should probably write this down. This. Okay. You've scanned some modified potatoes. Their rich color comes from the extra vitamins and minerals they carry. Those are potatoes? They're freaking huge. Looks like these potatoes were heavily affected by the toxin. 35% viable. Damn. Job. Alright, got it. Oh, wait, wasn't there another note that said sucks in all caps? So I guess the password is probably this job sucks. Okay, I think that's it. Wow, I scanned that from far away. An unknown species of flowers have sprung up in this hydroponic system. It appears to have mutated from another strain. I'm checking the flowers again to see if these are even viable as a food source. It appears not. They're too alien for our systems. They're barely 5% viable for processing. Lentil plant. Mostly intact. 89% viable, okay. Green bean vines. Once fast growing and efficient, but they appear withered and dry now. Not even 7% viable. Yeah, this one says sucks in all caps, right? Yep. So this job sucks. Well, this is a surprise. This plant is entirely unknown, and not one of the varieties commonly grown in the domes. Somehow it has thrived within the toxic environment. It's 92% viable. Wait, that wasn't correct? This job sucks? Or does it just need spaces? Oh, that's it. It just wanted spaces. Okay. Who put spaces in a password? Can you even put spaces in a password? I don't even know. It's a processing machine. Colonists would take crops and turn them into raw materials for the food processors and life support systems. However, it looks like it's been reconfigured. Judging by the data, Miss Leslie and her crew were trying to create an herbicide to fight off the invasive vines. It looks like they partly succeeded, but they may have had to abandon the dome before their work was finished. Why? Likely another seismic event forced them out. Someone began an automated procedure here, but didn't collect the results. By activating the machine again, you've confirmed the procedure. According to this, a successful herbicide was made. The machine should dispense it to the slot beside you. Well, that's convenient. Can we apply directly to vines? Well, I can think of two prime targets for that. Let's see what happens when you apply the herbicide to those vines. Seem to have recessed. You can access that area now. Good. Flower chamber. That printed photograph is faded and damaged, but I can still make out its general image. It appears to be of a breed of canine known as a corgi. The dog is at an earth farm of some kind. Corgis are often used for small-scale herding of animals, such as bovines. Their diminutive stature allows them to avoid being kicked. Aww. Maybe Miss Leslie knows something about this dog. You can ask her about it when you see her in the holosim chamber. Okay, she had a corgi, or liked corgis, or her family had a corgi or something. These were flowers that Miss Leslie was growing. She seems to be using substantial resources purely for aesthetic purposes. A certain percentage of dome production time and materials were dedicated to this, for psychological and community purposes. I don't believe this effort, however, was within the allotted amounts. Miss Leslie seems to have taken quite an interest in flowers. What is unclear, however, is whether these were grown during normal production or after the toxins set in. Either way, this broken bulb has been too greatly affected. We cannot use them for our purposes. Contained chicory, which was often used as a coffee substitute. The flowers look fairly healthy. 23% viable. Can I not take out these vines? It looks like there's a doorway behind it. Leafy Greens, Chamber 1. Duh, another body. I regret to inform you that you've discovered the body of Florent Marchand, horticultural technician. His remains are quite old, and your scan reveals little in how he died. There appears to be severe trauma to his skull. That could be from a heavy blow, or a sudden impact if he fell. There's a ladder there, suggesting he was using it to repair something, but I can't be sure. Well, he was always repairing stuff, right? So either he fell off the ladder, or perhaps someone pushed him? Maybe? That's specially modified garden cress. This variety is far more nutritious than its natural version. 78% viable. You seem to have scanned everything you're going to find in there. There isn't much more you can do. It's unfortunate that the facility is in such poor shape. At least we were able to salvage something for your food supply. This doesn't solve our long-term goal of stocking the escape ship, but at least it stabilizes things while we keep working. When you're ready, head back to the shuttle and plot a course back home. That'll be it for today. I don't think there are any more places I could use the herbicide on. I mean, there's lots of other places that have plants, but they don't appear to be blocking anything. Let's go. Poisonous plants have invaded that dome are strange indeed. We were fortunate to find even as few samples as we did for our use. It looks like Miss Leslie and her staff were scrambling to figure out how to combat the toxin and revive the food system. After the rift event, so many things fell apart. We're discovering more and more evidence of that. I suppose there's nothing more to be done there. You should get back home and out of that rain. Thank you. Can I make it? Can I make it to the end before it fades to black? Hey, I made it! That's as far as I could go. I win the video game. I'm glad to see you made it back unharmed. Please come to the core right away so we can process your findings. Alright, well, I think that's a good place to end this episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.